All right, so in this video, I want to talk to you about how I lost $300,000 with my junk removal business. One day, about 5 years ago, Shane comes to me and he says, "Listen, you want the good news or the bad news?" I always ask for the good first. I say, "All right, tell me the goods first." Kind of get me excited a little bit here. He told me, "You're going to be making a lot more money." Fantastic. So what's the bad? "You've lost about $300,000. Hey everyone, I'm Lee Godbold, founder and chief guide of Junk Removal Authority, where we help junk removal business owners make more money and live a better life. In this video, I'm gonna be telling you how I lost $300,000 with my junk removal business and how you can avoid doing the same in yours. Over the last few years, JRA has become the champion of independent junk removal business owners, helping them get over the hurdles of growing their business. Our junk removal marketing system has led to thousands upon thousands of jobs for our over 140 clients. If your dream is building a profitable business, then our junk removal marketing system will help you succeed against your competition and make your dream become a reality. For more information on the junk removal marketing system, click on the link in the description. Now let's get back to the topic at hand. That's the $300,000 topic. The year was 2016. We are coming up on our 5-year anniversary in business. But the bottom line to the profit of the business was getting out of hand. We went from a bottom line profit of somewhere around 20 grand a month to about 3 grand a month. Add in our truck payments and we were literally just barely treading water. And this was in June, during the busy season. If things kept this way, we were gonna be unable to make it through the winter. The advertising costs had gone completely insane. For a $1 million a year business, we were spending something like 25%, so $250,000 of our revenue back out in advertising cost. But I did not want to quit advertising because listen, that's how we were getting our jobs. That's how we were getting a ton of work. Stopping advertising was not going to fix our problems. We had to figure out a way to make it work more efficiently, to get more for what we're spending, or to reduce our spend and still get the same amount of work. I knew without a shadow of a doubt the problem was in the Google Ads campaign. We had spent a ton of money on it and we were still spending a bunch of money. I had been self-managing this campaign since the start of our business and we had done pretty well with it. We'd built ourselves up to $1 million a year business. When we first started with Google Ads, we were one of the early adopters to it. So that means that not a lot of our competition was doing it and Google was also just trying to get as many people on the platform as they could. So our clicks were something like $3 per click, and that was getting us up to like the first or second position. Now, after that 4 or 5 years, we were at $15 a click for the exact same position. I decided the time was right to find someone to help me run this Google Ads campaign. So I looked around and I located Shane and I brought him on. Over the next several months, we studied past data. We made tweaks, we made changes to this campaign, and we saw consistent improvement. And then Shane came to me and said, "Listen, we've lost this $300,000. At that point, I felt a combination of excitement and disappointment. That's 300K straight off the bottom line that we lost. I asked him, "Well, how did we lose this money? Where did it go?" He said, "We had a ton of bad clicks since we started the campaign that equaled about $300,000. We were showing for broad match, something you never want to do, almost never anyway, which Google actually recommends you use broad match. And we were showing for many search terms related to trash, garbage, etc. Search terms that simply don't convert for junk removal companies at a high enough rate in order to warrant having them out there. We initiated those changes and instantly our profit came back and then some. Over the next year or so, we further improved the campaign and then started Junk Removal Authority in order to help other junk removal businesses manage ads campaigns. You'd be amazed at the wasted money we've seen when we've looked at both self-managed ads campaigns as well as ad campaigns managed from other ads agencies. Most people simply don't get the junk removal industry, at least not from a marketing perspective. They don't understand what to show for and what's really more important, what not to show for. And they waste a lot of money, which goes straight to lining Google's pockets. If you're interested in running Google Ads for your junk removal business or finding out what kind of money is being wasted with your current campaign, then make sure to check out the link in the description of this video to learn about the junk removal marketing system. I appreciate you watching. If you did find it helpful, please like it and subscribe to our channel and leave us a little comment. We love reading what people have to say. I'm Lee Godbold with Junk Removal Authority, where we help junk removal business owners make more money and live a better life.